I'm currently pursuing my engineering, computer science. I'm doing my second.
Joined Daffodil's Toastmasters Club, but somehow again I was not very good at it. So let me see, I have the right place to really practice my speaking skills.
So before I proceed further, I would request general evaluator, since today there is only one speaker, can I, with your liberty, can I extend for 15 minutes of my presidential address?
Make it 10 minutes if you don't like.
I would try my best. If it is interesting, the topic is, then it would definitely bear on your palm.
No, that presidential address has to be
10 minutes.
Fine, I'll try to keep it short.
We'll get a table topic later.
Okay. So, my fault, my failure is my success. So, everyone does mistake here or commit a mistake. Right? Yes or no?
Yes.
So do you all commit a mistake and learn from your mistakes or from your faults?
Yes.
You even learn mistakes or you even learn a lesson from other person what he commits a mistake or a fault. Yes or no?
Yes.
I want a loud answer. Yes or no? Yes. It's like as if like you people don't know mistake at all, you're telling. And there's one more category of people where they know that it is wrong but still they commit the mistake. Yes or no?
Yes.
And they consistently commit that mistake with pride. Yes?
Yes.
So today I'm going to highlight the third category of people where they consistently commit the mistake even though they know it is wrong. But still they are very proud of it. For that I would like to give you a small example. Since Toastmaster BSP Prasad has already highlighted that I work for an amazing deals company which is none other than Amazon. So right now we are having Great Indian Deal going on. So please purchase from that, we have better deals from it compared to Flipkart or any other. So my role in Amazon is as a cybercrime investigator. So I deal with the fraudulent activity what goes on Amazon platform. So we are the people who investigate the fraud activities going on. So I would like to share one such example what was happened in India. It's an Indian case. So it was a mistake committed by our own investigators in our Amazon, though knowing that it was a wrong thing what they were doing from a long period of time. I joined Amazon just 8 months ago and it's been almost like 4 months to 5 months. I was not even understanding the process, how it runs. But still I was, you know, able to hang on to my team. And I used to always have a lot of discouragement from my boss because he used to tell me that I used to never, you know, achieve my investigations per hour. So we have a target like in 1 hour we need to complete so and so investigations. So if you see, I am the least performer in my whole team till date, even today. But every time he comes, he calls me to his room, he tells me, Rohit, you need to pull up your socks and make sure that your investigations goes high. But unfortunately or fortunately, I got one case where when I deep dived into it, it was a big gold mine of a fraud for me. And the case goes like this. So in India, there was one lady who used to order from Amazon only electronic gadgets. And the gadgets were used to be fan, a mobile phone or an electronic watch. Smart watches and so on, it might be even mixer, anything. And this lady, whenever she used to order from online, she used to get the product and then she used to return the product back to Amazon saying that the product is defective piece. Every single time she did this, the seller used to come back to us and say that there's one customer who used to return us the product saying that it's a defective piece. So we told the seller that it's really might be defective piece because we are more customer obsessed. So whatever the customer says, we believe them. Though we believe what the seller says, it's only 10%, 90% we abide with the customer. So this case we got repeatedly back to us. We kept on rejecting the seller complaint, whatever he was trying to convey the message to us. And this was happened 5 times. And the 6th time, I got this case. And I'm a guy, I don't rely on my previous investigator's audit or the annotations, what they write. So what I used to do, I used to go to the primary complaint, the first initial complaint, and I used to check what was the issue from the seller side or from the customer side. And then when I deep dived, I found out that this lady, what she used to do was, she used to take the product, dismantle the product, take out the original item, the original working condition of the product, and replace it with the fake or counterfeit product. So suppose you take the fan, ceiling fan, it has a coil inside it, if you all know that. So there are only 4 screws on the fan. If you just dismantle the 4 screws, you can remove the coil. Coil would cost you nearly like 800 rupees, roughly. It's a copper coil winding. And she used to replace it with a normal local one or a burnt coil winding. And she used to say that this is a defective piece and she used to return back to the seller. And seller came back to us saying that the customer is doing this repeatedly many number of times. And our investigators failed to investigate that thing. They always rejected it. And second, this has become a big issue and it's been escalated to the legal team of our Amazon. Because the product what she bought was worth 40 to 30,000. And every time she bought a product, it was always used to be an electronic gadget. So to make it easy, I would write. So this is the electronic gadget what the customer used to always buy. And what was the amount she used to buy? What was the budget?
10 to 30.
10 to 30. So shall I put less than 50k? Yeah. And always she used to buy the product when it was a deal time. Like right now we are Great Indian Sale. She used to always purchase the product only in deal. And she used to always purchase the product in such a way that it used to always be a new launched seller on Amazon. So when a new launch seller, you know, sells a product, he sells for a lower cost because he wants to sell his product as fast as possible and he wants to come on the product page, PDP product page, as a buy box. And third, every time she bought the product, she used to buy from a different address and different credit cards. Different address and different credit card. And whenever she used to buy the product, it used to always be in a large volume or a large quantity. Like she doesn't buy like one single fan, she'll buy like 10-15 in a quantity. She used to refund the product. And whenever she buys, she used to make sure that she does a credit card payment so that she'll be in good books of Amazon, thinking that she doesn't take cash on delivery, though it is a huge amount of product what she's buying from us. Now, the seller came back to us saying that she is doing a fraudulent activity, she's giving us a defective piece. So how would you identify that what the seller is saying the truth or what the customer is saying the truth? Any guess?
No.
Investigate.
How will you investigate? How will you like make even a guess that what both are saying right now?
Inside there will be a batch number, something will be done.
Okay.
I think you asked the seller, how is he saying that?
Exactly. First point, what was? Ask the seller. So what I did was, I asked the seller. my fellow investigators failed to do that. I asked the seller, like, what you're saying is truth or not. So what he did was, when our next time when she ordered the product, he always took a photograph and sent it to her. And then he sent those photographs to us. And our investigators failed to open that pictures because it was an encrypted attachment to us. So you need to call the car seller and ask him what is the password. He would give us a link and then we need to open and see the attachment. And that's where first thing our investigators failed. I'll drop this and just drop it.
You have to write it back.
Yeah. And second, just because the seller sent a pic, do you think you will agree to it?
No.
No. So I did the same thing even with a customer. I asked her, can you send me the pictures which you felt was a defective piece? And you know what? Astonishingly, she dismantled all the 20 parts, the whole product, and she has taken photograph and sent me for each part. Do you think any customer has so much patience to dismantle all the 20 fans and send you a picture?
Yes. 20 fans.
20 fans. I don't think, as a customer, I don't think I would ever do that. Maybe one or two fans, I would dismantle, send the picture and say rest all are the same.
We are the customers. We have a lot of patience. See that.
So, that was a black spot or a doubt what I got in my mind. And the third thing was, and after that, I realized that whenever she used to order from a different credit card, she failed to realize that it was from the same address. So suppose I and my father are staying in the same place, we have the same address, common sharing. But the credit card, what I use, what he uses is a different credit card. So that was the catch. I realized that she used to order from a different seller account, email ID, but different address. The credit card address was the same. Then we identified that she was the only seller who was doing this fraudulent activity. And then we raised an escalation towards her and we raised an FIR against her. So this case was a goldmine case for me, which has helped me improve my investigations. And now my boss came back to me and took me to the room and he asked me, Rohit, you have done a great job. But he even told me that, why did you do DPAR? What was the requirement? I just simply said, sir, the people who are sitting outside are just working in Amazon. But I am doing the right work, what I am being paid for. That was the only difference between them and me. So today I stood in the limelight. And today, there is no one to question me why I take so long for any investigation. So, if you all know that you are committing a mistake, you know that you are repeatedly doing the same mistake, but still you are not trying to rectify it. You will never ever learn from it. So, that's the message I would like to pass on to you people. And I don't want to go into detail about this because it would be a different session once again. Okay. Now, I would like to further welcome. The next person would be taking the dais. This person is a very soft-spoken person. He's a businessman and very cool person because he deals with refrigerators and air conditioning. And he is very tuned and controlled person when he talks. So if you have a good, you know, communicate. We have a good 5 minutes chat with him, you will get to know what kind of a person he is. So please put your hands together to Mr. Cool, DDM, MK Prasad.